This video is a guide about biometric enrollment using HPV Biometric Capture software. The aim of this video is not only to show how the program works, but also to be a guide for best practices when taking a frontal photo that complies with the A-code specifications, as well as the correct fingerprint capture in 4:4:2 mode with the best quality possible.
For the correct photo capture, the background should be white, regular, and the applique must look directly at the camera, with his or her eyes open to normal expression. If applicant wear glasses, they must be totally transparent. For the capture of the frontal facial photo, the applicant will be told what suitable position in front of the camera is. The recommended distance between the camera and the applicant is about 1 or 2 meters, and the camera has to be at the same height as the applicant's eyes. So the height of the tripod has to be modified before every capture, and the camera has to focus the whole applicant's face. On the other hand, the hair or the hijab shall not cover the face, and the light in the room shall not produce shadows in the face. In addition, other people or objects should not appear in the picture, such as the mother's lap or a toy. Children under 5 do not need to have a neutral expression or to look directly at the camera. Infants under 1 didn't have their eyes open. If the baby's head needs to be held, the hands holding it should not be shown. May any incident happen during the capture, there are 2 people in the capture area, there is not enough light, there is no face in the photo, etc., an error message will appear saying the capture must be repeated. Although the program detects no anomalies, the capture can be repeated as many times as needed. If we consider that the capture is correct, press the Accept button to proceed to the fingerprint capture. The screen has 3 capture zones. Right hand, 4 fingers, left hand, 4 fingers, and thumbs, 2 fingers. In the right hand, the first finger on the left will be the forefinger. In the left hand, the first finger on the right will be the forefinger. It is important to take some considerations to avoid problems with the visa data in the Schengen border. Before proceeding to the capture, clean the glass of the scanner and check if the applicant's fingers are clean and dry. If they are not, use one of the towelettes given by the operator. To avoid this setback, the room temperature should be between 18 degrees centigrade to 25 degrees centigrade. Make sure that the fingers are quite separated while doing the capture. However, they should never surpass the limit of the capture area. The fingers cannot be crossed and the hand cannot be placed the wrong way on the scanner. When taking the fingerprints of the thumbs, the hands cannot be crossed either. Moreover, the hands must be kept still during the capture and the pressure applied has to be adequate. Neither excessive, the fingerprint won't be taken correctly, nor low, the quality of the fingerprints will be very low. If more pressure is needed, we can use the other hand to press on. To start with the right hand capture process, press the capture button that appears in the right hand zone. Then, the applicant shall put his right hand on the scanner, pressing the 4 fingers on the glass. Make sure the hand placed on the scanner is the one we want to capture, and press from the fingertips. If the fingers are outside the capture area, a red signal will indicate which way they need to move the hand to. While the capture is being done, a color indicator will show if the fingerprint is correct. When the program has captured the 4 fingerprints, it will return to the previous screen so that we can see the fingerprints taken correctly positioned. Every fingerprint has to be colored green to indicate the quality is good. After capturing the fingerprints of both hands, capture those of the thumbs. The thumbs shall be centered at the bottom of the scanner. The pressure has to be put in the center bottom part of the scanner. To send the fingerprints, press Confirm the Capture button. On the other hand, the applicant must be asked if he or she wears a bandage or if any of his or her fingers is missing, even if it's partially. Tell the applicant to show you his or her hand. If a defect is detected, we shall select the right option, not available, amputated, by pressing the selector in the top right corner of the fingerprint. If we cannot capture a whole group of fingers due to any of the reasons explained before, there is a combo box in the top right corner of the hand to be captured, where we can choose between one of these three options: normal, not available, and amputated. If any of these fingerprints is red, it means that it's a poor quality fingerprint, and the process has to be repeated at least three times until its quality is good. If the applicant places the fingers of the right hand on the area intended for the left hand fingers, the screen will show the fingerprints in a violet color, which means that the fingerprints are duplicated. In this case, press Clean button and repeat the capture of the fingerprints. To improve the quality of the fingerprints, ask the applicant to apply more pressure to the glass. If it's needed, the operator can help the applicant by pressing the hand to the glass. If even after three retries the fingerprint is still bad quality, send it anyway. Avoid, whenever possible, pressing the clean button, since this action deletes all the fingerprints cache of that group. So every fingerprint of the hand will have to be recaptured. Every time the fingerprints are captured, the higher quality fingerprints are the ones that are saved in the cache, deleting the previous ones of lesser quality for every finger.
The hardware used in this video, such as the webcam and the scanner, are only an example, since the solution offers a wide interoperability of capture devices. The same enrollment solution is offered in kiosk-like architectures, which allows carrying out the same process in self-assisted mode and being monitored from another checkpoint. BioIdenti solutions have been deployed for enrollments carried out by Spanish police in the border or from consular posts in the visa and passport management framework.